Well, Prime Minister Anthony Albanese is bracing for the defection of the government's youngest senator. Afghan-born Fatima Payman is expected to formally split from Labor later this week in a protest over recognition of Palestine, her mother calling her a hero.
Fatima Payman cut a lonely figure, leaving the lodge after a prime ministerial dressing down.
Have you been expelled?
Isolated by her own actions.
This path has been chosen by her, not for her.
Once in Labor's firm embrace, the renegade WA senator has been exiled after crossing the floor in recognition of Palestinian statehood and then promising to do it again.
The Labor Party is sanctioning one of their own more strongly than they're prepared to sanction a genocidal Israeli government.
Senator Payman has recruited the so-called preference whisperer, Glenn Drury, who's previously advised independence, an act of disloyalty to some in Labor, even if her supporter base is growing.
We hold the utmost respect for her actions and her activism.
She's also energised her hometown Muslim community.
Her courage and fortitude and bravery has to be applauded.
The imam of Perth's biggest mosque saying Fatima Payman had his backing in or outside the Labor Party.
The religion of Islam speaks about standing for justice even if it be against your own parents and your own relatives.
Senator Payman's mother flagging a hero's welcome for her daughter at Perth Airport on Friday to show our solidarity for doing the right thing. Nine News understands Senator Payman has no intention of quitting politics, nor does she intend changing her stance on Palestinian statehood, putting her in clear conflict with the Labor Party room. The Prime Minister barely disguising his frustration at the prospect of losing her from the Labor caucus.
I expect further announcements in coming days, which will explain exactly what the strategy has been over now more than a month.
Andrew Probyn, Nine News.